See that it's a very good afternoon, I will call it, and a very good afternoon to all distinguished friends over here. We are here to mark the centennial of CPC. We gather here at the prestigious Pakistan Institute of Peace and Development, a diplomatic studies, to celebrate CPC's cultivated new culture of cooperation and partnership. We have reached this stage after China's long struggle and huge sacrifices. In this context, I would like to place my views on some basics of CPC. The first basic is, it is a force of national liberation. Founding of PRC was the first primary task of CPC. It is CPC's most glorious patriotic accomplishment. Without liberation from the devastating colonial and feudal impact, a country cannot choose its independent path, be rich, unified, confident, and strong. And this is, perhaps we can take it as a very big lesson from China. The second is, CPC's ability to maintain a red bloodline. The red line also holds a preemptive defensive strategy on the socialist governance system with Chinese characteristics and China's territorial integrity. I think I don't have to explain it any further over here. And the third basics of CPC is its ability to maintain and value history and culture of partnership and cooperation. Because CPC always wanted to share it. That is one of the fundamental basics. It has never said that we just want to prosper and develop and be strong. And that is something which encourages a country like Nepal very much. And I will just give you an example over here. In a sense, Silk Road has become a powerful analogy for modern Belt and Road initiated cooperation for global reconstruction and connectivity. The new Silk Road rejuvenates China, land and maritime civilization. So what I'm saying that the root is in history, which CPC has never forgotten. And they are regenerating it, re-innovating it, and revitalizing it, which is a great sort of things. So always history teaches us, and we have to learn out of it. And here I would just like to add a new dimension, which has been added over here institutionally. The latest inter-regional addition to partnership and cooperation is the Chongqing-based China South Asia Center for Poverty Elevation and Cooperative Development within the BRC framework. Here I am mentioning it because Nepal is also part of South Asia, and poverty elevation is perhaps our biggest task over here. And we have been very much fragmented over this task. And what I think that because of my experience in China and especially working in the rural areas, I can just tell you one thing that even in China is a country, when once I was working in Xinjiang, a farmer was asking me that how to make the Chinese agricultural products competitive as China has become a member of WTO. I worked in Guyana, I worked in elsewhere in South Asia as well. I have been working in Nepal. Nowhere a farmer has asked me this kind of question. And that shows even the level of the farmer, the kind of consciousness, you see that, the kind of awareness they have in terms of becoming very competitive. That was something I always remember. Now the final thing, the basic thing which I would like to put over here is CPSC's futuristic vision. While celebrating the centenary, it wishes to make the occasion a trailblazer for forging intergenerational friendly ties with people all over the world. This is indeed a legitimate and genuine wish as confrontational ecology floats up. And this is rather we have to be very attentive to as a neighbor, being as a neighbor of China. The 21st century double centenary happiness to China, to neighbors and to the world, sure faces a quality transformation characterized by distributive justice and new security standards. And this is something that I think even on the border management sort of thing, China has been trying to encourage us to come up with the new security guidelines. Even you see that in the context of the COVID, because that was never a consideration in our border management. And when we say border management, it relates to the mobility of the people, especially the local people, which is something of very high significance to us. And here, I would like to end this small note with my gratefulness to the distinguished organizers for giving me this opportunity to share some of the views on this historic occasion. Thank you very much.